All the furniture, everything, yes, we will be bachelor.
Basically what it's saying is that people have different vision, there is a romantic vision, there is a realism, etc. But basic source of all creativity is everyday life. That was basically what cinema is all about. All the results are very different. I mean, this chap is making a sword out of his own cheese by beating them into transforming them. And then a love story is on. Anyway.
The next, these are murals, several murals of the Burnham that he did.
They are quite next. Large paintings.
Very large paintings. That place name.
Thank you.
This is when democracy was ushered in, and this is a letter, 100 plants.
Size
guess. This is 8 feet by 16 feet.
I just wondered if these plants can live together from various countries and live in various temperatures. What is wrong with us? Mm-hmm. We are sort of dividing ourselves in all sorts of little groupings and chisms and all that. This is also this is 8 foot by 4 is like one panel. This is
8 by 16. This is, you might recognize this, it is outside the Alhambra. And this is a tile mural. The tile mural was a tradition of the Mughal period, and Idaz has tried to revive it, though he
the Mughals had to cut it. So I sort of cut it before firing them, because you know these were big, large size things. And the subject, since it was going to be in a very public place like Alhambra, yeah, bachche bhi aate hain bade, so I tried to put all the figures, the children could also sort of identify hey, murga, chaj, you know all that. So I tried to make it quite elementary and yet depictive of life and co-fields of the Bajar.
These
are
parts. Just to show you कि वो कैसे stones लगे हुए हैं, एक-एक like a jigsaw puzzle was fitted in. I tell you, this was a mammoth task. चलें आगे बेटा, इस तरह एक-एक fit किया था ये. And of course, Mustafa helped out in that.
आज उसकी ही था, उसका मैंने सारे तो बोले.
This is mural on Lahore. Achha, these are two murals that that are called the red signal. The red signal means stop. Here is it starts from right to left. It reads from right to left, and here is the Adam and Eve in Garden of Eden. And what happens is the world thrives, they thrive. These are motifs of all civilizations, great civilizations. Bogies of Midden Hand, then there are the miniatures, then there are pieces taken from symbols taken from anything of excellence that happened. And then what happens is we arrive in the 20th century. And what is the 20th century doing? There is the mushroom of the atom bomb, and there is the difference between these figures and that figure over there. This is a figure taken from Munch's The Bride, and the scream, is it? Okay, the scream. and it is something to scream about. The plants are singed and the Murga is heralding the doom of the world. Stop, it says. Stop. Chaliyagi. This is a sequel to that, and at this time the only difference is the red light has come nearer. The danger is near. Nearer. Chaliyagi.
Incidentally, when this mural has disappeared, I don't know where it is. So it
is.
Next. Did anybody find it?
Snow again. Flowers. Next. Next. The you see, as I mentioned earlier, I repeat it again, light was a symbol, light against dark, hope against despair. So next, then ये अब 21st century आगे, the violence, the next many pictures are about the violence of the 21st century. This is Mothers Unite, because really mothers are the only ones, mothers are the only ones who can unite and maybe prevent, put a break on the terrible, on the suicidal race for arms that's going on in the world.
This takes the Dilip's mother takes the form of the cross. And Madonna is Madonna. But then Madonna has three who have been slaughtered. So there are multiple lances in this.
This was, these are two paintings on lamentation, called lamentation. After the massacres, after the...
Bloody landscape.
The fall of man. Actually, these are a bit... The slides are a bit mixed up. You can see that painting over there, against which you are leaning. Actually, these are, wait a second, these are two, then during this violence, then he painted these two prayer mats, he says. This one and the next one. These are two prayer mats. And this is rain, rain that is a symbol of life, a dead earth brought to life with rain. And this is our particular ray of sunshine.
Just a moment.
And that's it.
For inviting me and organizing such a...
Mic is not working.
Mic is not working?
No.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
So, thank you. Thanks a lot for inviting and organizing such a wonderful event. I really enjoyed your talk and the overview and insightful observation and comments and analysis about Mia Sahib ke kaam ke baare mein. शुरू में बड़ी अपनी मजे की बात कही थी कि व्हेन इजाज साहब वाज इन इंग्लैंड एंड वो एस्टेब्लिशमेंट के से जरा होके वापस आ गए. मेरा ख्याल है कि शायद इंग्लैंड में भी है एस्टेब्लिशमेंट. मेरा तो वी आर द प्रिविलेज बट आई थिंक अदर कंट्रीज ऑल्सो विच एंजॉय दैट. लेकिन मैं बैठा हुआ सोच रहा था मैं कहाँ फंस गया हूँ. आई एम इन अ वेरी प्रिविलेज पोजिशन एंड आई एम इन अ वेरी ऑकवर्ड पोजिशन ऑल्सो. मैं कबाब में हड्डी प्लीज डोंट टेक मी इन रॉन्ग. मैं मियाँ बीवी की नहीं बात कर रहा, मैं बात कर रहा हूँ राइटर एंड द सब्जेक्ट. एंड आई फील वेरी ऑकवर्ड टू टॉक अबाउट समन जो कि इतने सालों से जिनकी एक मेजर कंट्रीब्यूशन है आर्ट में, आर्ट राइटिंग में, आर्ट टीचिंग में, सपोर्टिंग आर्टिस्ट. सो आई विल स्टार्ट विद ये जो एक है रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन अ मैन एंड अ वूमन, बीइंग अ मैन एंड बीइंग अ हस्बैंड एंड वाइफ. एज अ चाइल्ड इन माय विलेज I saw an old couple who did not have any blood relation but still looked so much like each other as if they were first cousins or twins. Being married for more than 60 years and living with each other in the same house created physical resemblance in otherwise different human beings. But even if not facial features, yet people who have lived with each other, or should I say survived with each other, start sharing certain habits, customs, and views. Many a times I used to wonder what is the difference between Mia Ijazul Hasan and Dr. Nusrat Hasan. Since both are artists, art teachers, authors, supporters of young and other artists, and loving hosts. Now finally my curiosity is satiated with this book. Ijazul Hasan, Five Decades of Painting by Nusrat Hasan. Glancing at the front cover, cover page, I realize there's a difference in their apparently similar surnames. One which is written with two S and the other and other one is just with one S. Please don't expect me to go further on who is who because it would be best to consult the book itself for that matter. But not only for this the minor matter. The book is a remarkable piece of writing to know the art and life of Ijazul Hasan. Mexican author Jose Vasconcelos, somewhere describing books, said, and I quote, he said, "A book, like a journey, is begun in anxiety and finished in melancholy." But the present monograph is certainly a book which started in excitement and ended with a great sense of pleasure and achievement. Feelings which I'm sure are shared by every reader. Did I just say every reader? Because we all know who and where is the reader of an art book. As an art student, I never read a single line printed in an art book. I just focus on the reproductions of art pieces. Although, since I acquired another profession of an art writer, still I don't read an artist's monograph. I leaf through and enjoy the artworks printed in it. However, the book by Musarrat Hasan changed my routine. Both the author and her subject require a serious engagement with the text. Since the text refers to a person who, like a banyan tree, is above many artists. Like the tree, providing shadow, comfort, and company. Which does not mean that Ijazul Hasan's work has influenced many artists. Because despite of him painting for more than 50 years, formal aspects of his art are not spotted in the works of any other artists. Working in his time, he is unique. Actually, in that case, he is not the only one. Because another artist, Sadegan, who although caused a lot of forgery and copying, never had a painter after him, who can be recognized as inspired from the aesthetics of Sadegan. Perhaps the reason for the inimitable individuality of these artists is that both do not belong to the routine of art school trainings, where students follow their tutors' work. In my view, this is a blessing because it adds the openness to the ideas and imagery of a painter who cannot be reduced to a clan. He is above and beyond art world because for him there's a work much larger, interesting, intriguing, and important than the small circle of artists conversing and quarreling with each other. In fact, in the case of Ijazul Hasan, art is one part of his creative and active personality. Because besides being a painter, he is an educator, politician, and a writer. The person who wrote first comprehensive book on Pakistani art. But more than all these dimensions, probably the most significant aspect of his personality is what described by the author of the book, and I quote, "A prolific communicator, and he likes to express himself at length." So, regardless if you meet him on the opening of an art exhibition, during a seminar, or at his house late afternoon, you will encounter a perpetual investigating mind who is not a conformist and is open to visit and revisit position and practices. He is one of those rare individuals in our art and culture who in one conversation can comment on global politics, cite Sophocles, quote Eliot, analyze local cuisine, and contextualize Venetian painters of Renaissance. The book, a remarkable piece of writing by Dr. Musarrat Hasan, offers a glimpse to this larger-than-life figure. Since the author has the privilege to witness and share the genesis of most of his works and his ways of thinking, the book provides an insight into his painting from various periods. From his earlier works at Quetta in late 50s, जो अभी हमने देखे, to later cubist stylization, we have seen that also. The book serves as a gentle yet insightful guide to take us at that phase of his art which determined his pictorial expression, a visual language that appears at its best in paintings such as Thar. We have seen the, I think when we were talking about 70s and 80s, Thar, the My Lai Massacre, the Green Revolution, and the Rifle Butt. The last painting I was privileged to include in the exhibition of Pakistani art at the National Gallery of Modern Art in Bombay, and was happily surprised when an Indian art critic expressed her surprise on seeing Izazul Hasan's canvas. She said, "I didn't know that artists were working like this in 70s in Pakistan." I wanted to correct her. "Madam, not artists, but the artist. Only Izazul Hasan. Only because he is one of the few artists for whom there is hardly a difference between art and life. Because for Izazul Hasan, art is a way of communicating with others, but more than anyone else, with yourself as a painter." Musarrat Hasan reconstructed the life, words and works of the artist who happens to live in the same house, bit by bit, but very meticulously, in order to know how the mind of an artist works, who is not just interested in political subjects, but his canvas addressed issues of society as large. His work, if on the one hand connects to the history of modernism in Pakistan, at the same instance, it deals with the pictorial sophistication of a classicist, something that must have come from his readings of literature at the Cambridge University. Now when I look around, I see many young people who must have been toddlers at the turn of century, rather at the turn of millennium. And I recall the most crucial concern at the turn of the century that haunted everyone, precisely everyone who was using computer.